this race, you know, is a nice rally and also same time is very difficult rally. I have a lot of experience. I win 5 times from 6 times, you know.
I expect to have a lot of fun. It's fun roads here. I was here last year. I just hope not to get lost.
When someone asks me if this will be a good rally, I always use an expression that we say in my country, in Portugal, is that I cannot say, because rallies are like melons. You must open the melon to taste it and to know if it's good or not. So let's wait that the rally starts, and I will tell you later if it's a good rally or not.
Thank you for everyone. I would like to thank the Qatar Motorsport Federation for hosting a fantastic event.
As you know, it's been an exciting season so far, and we're hoping that we see strong competition in this round. So welcome everybody.
Yes, we have a bad crash in Abu Dhabi, last day of Abu Dhabi Desert Challenge. Yes, I now 17 days from Abu Dhabi race, and we have a big crash there, you know. We was leading by 1 hour 45 minutes. We are really lucky, you know, not anything broke, but a lot of damage in the muscles. I've been 10 days in the hospital, you know, for treatment and to get ready, you know, for this race, because it's very important, you know, this is a motorsport, you know, we need to get ready very fast.
The super special stage, it's used to determine the starting order for the real rally.
There's the magic of the cross country, that you don't know where you are going. So, but the prologue is very, very important, because you will choose the starting order for the first day. Everybody wants to start quite far to see the line.
You know, super special stages are always fun. They always come up with, you know, jumps and things like that. So for me, it's, of course, I need to get a good time, to get a good starting position, but also not to make mistakes, because you make a mistake here and your rally is over.
It's first time, you know, to have the prologue here in Losail circuit, you know, but I think we look in the map, it looks really nice, and use some road from motocross, you know. And then you have like a fast track, but okay, we'll see.
Yeah, we have around, I think, 27 countries in the race. We have a lot of them, actually, that for the first time they come to the Qatar Cross Country, which was a fantastic addition for this race. We worked a lot with the UAE to make sure that it's easier for them to finish the race there and come here. So it seems that what we worked on, you know, worked this time.
It's good, good special. It's a lot of water, a lot of mud. We enjoy it.
This will be the fourth event of the championship, and it is a fact that the first three events had three different winners, which is already a proof that we have a very open championship.
finished second in Abu Dhabi, but you know, this is different rally. Everybody's saying it's completely different. It's not dunes rally, it's much more fast rally and very complicated for navigation. So new challenge for us, and especially for my co-driver.
We are coming here to Qatar Rally to get as slot as possible experience, to get some navigation skills together, and to see how is our speed comparing to the top drivers.
For me, if you know the event, usually you can have put an expectation of where you want to avoid. But when everything is new for you, you're just going there. What will be the surprises coming now? So I'm going to, in my head, just saying that I want to keep it smooth, relaxed, and feel. If I feel good, I will try to drive in a good pace. If I felt that something is not right from navigation or the terrain, I will try to back off. Just trying to keep the learning process and improve my pace.
It's my first year in the cross-country rallies in the car. I've done it 3 times on a quad, 3 Dakars is my 4th. It's all about learning, you know, it's a learning curve for me. It's important to finish every rally. All of what I learned, 80%, what I'm learning now is to drive a new machine. But the terrain is the same, navigation is the same. Reading the terrain, reading the bumps, the type of terrains, the countries we go through, everything is the same, you know. So for me, it's just a new machine and how to be as fast as you can and as safe as you can in that machine, you know. It's the reason why we did well in Dakar and Abu Dhabi and Dubai is because of the quad experience, of course.
You know, Qatar Rally is very, very fast, you know, and also very hard, you know, a lot of stone and rough road, you know. But okay, like what I say, you need a lot of experience of kind of this terrain, you know. But okay, we try to do every day in good strategy, and we try to push some place and slow down some place, you know. We need to be clever, you know, because to win this race, you need to be clever.
Yeah, stage was very different for me. Yeah, first time we've been, yeah. Very difficult to find the road. So, not a bad day considering the drama.
We had some problem, a small problem with our car.
Hello, we are okay. We are okay, hello.
But finally we are here, that's most important.
Yeah, it was very, all the cups were coming after each other. It was so quick, and then in the end the dust. Not easy in the dunes. But Przygonski catched us. And then we stayed with him, and then in the end we catched him again. But now my window is broken, so.
Today's stage was really good, you know, tough navigation. We were doing really well. I think we were at CP2 in third position overall. We're catching some cars, and then 20 kilometers before the dunes, we had a puncture. You know, I was careful the whole time, and then I had a puncture, but it took us 3 minutes to change it because, you know, my hand, we lost a minute for that, but you know, the rally is long. We did a good job. I think I'm happy with my driving and with Xavier, and he's happy as well with that, everything. So overall, we're really happy.
From beginning, it was really good stage, and we have a good lead, and after we have a problem, you know, with the steering bump. You know, it was not easy, you know, to turn the cars, and then we get other problem, you know, with the gearbox, and we stuck in the third gear. But okay, I am quite happy, you know, to be here in the finish, and we lose only 10 or 11 minutes. I am sure tomorrow we can fix everything.
You lost your power steering?
Yeah, from 90 kilometers.
Really?
Yes.
And hit thunderstorm?
No, no. It's like failed, yes. After gearbox.
And after gearbox?
Yes. All the way, you know. I said, hey. Flat out tomorrow, you know.
The first 3 minutes before the start, because you never know what you have to do. But then when I just see the green light, I get very calm and I love the feeling after.
It's in my stomach, it's not in my head. It's of course you're anxious, you're you know, the good thing about rallies is you don't start in a line, so this adrenaline that you get in a circuit racing, so but you still of course have everything that rushes through your head, and those 3 minutes are the longest 3 minutes you can ever have. But once you start, that's good, it's perfect.
Yeah, sometimes you know you're thinking how will be the prologue, you know, fast, slow. But okay, I think just when we put the helmets, you know, and we start, and we don't think about anything, you know, and we try to do every day a good job.
You know, we do in South Africa, we do a lot of racing like this, so the only thing that is different is the navigation. So we come to races like this to learn the navigation. It's very similar to Dakar, and you know, we've got no dunes in South Africa, so it's again good to come here and learn how to obviously travel in the dunes.
Xavier Panseri, co-driver of Mohamed Abouissa. We are together since Dakar 2017. Yeah, it's for me, it's not my first driver. I had something like 50 before, but it's one of the first who never had a co-driver in the past.
Yeah, my first rally, I have to admit to you that I couldn't trust. It wasn't Xavier, but it was very difficult. You know, I had a 5 kilometer stage. I had to learn the roadbook by heart in my head, because it's not easy to, you know, to listen to someone. You read it yourself. And if you want to know again, you read it again, instead of asking again your co-driver.
It's the point who is a little bit difficult. Yeah. To be concentrated in both ways, concentrate on driving and concentrate on listening. When you feel that the driver is a little bit tense or something like that, you have to find a way to give him confidence and let's say fun in the car. Because when you are making fun in the car, I mean fun in driving, and you are always better. The results are better, and your driving is more smooth.
You know, sometimes your competitor, the terrain, you know, you need to be really focused and to challenge the difficult rally. But there is Mini Driver, there is Peugeot, there is Toyota also, you know, a lot of good driver, you know, who's competing all the championship and also in Dakar, you know.
Today is a lucky stage. We have problem with car. We bent the arm in the ditch, and we try to continue. After we in 260k, we plan to, I think the car, he can't continue because it's worse. And we exit and we come here and we see tomorrow with Valenti 100 hour. Only enjoy tomorrow.
Today this was good stage for us, and we win the stage, and now we are leading the rally. But it's a little bit difficult with the navigation, but okay, we did good job. Matthieu make a good navigation, and we are happy.
It was not easy day, but it's better than yesterday. For sure, the first section was sandy and dunes. The middle section was rocky. You know, after half of the stage, when we started catching all the cars, we got lost for almost 5 minutes, which is so pity. You do really good pace and you think you can keep the momentum, and suddenly you get lost. After that, we came back the last section, again 70 k's from the last section. We didn't get, we just too much diverting, too much off pace. It was over bad rocks, and this was very slow. So we lost a lot of time over there. But you know, I'm learning over here. Good that I finished second today, but for me, it's the purpose is to learn, to improve my capability on cross country. And yeah, at least we are here, and every day is a learning for me.
Today was a good stage. Finally, we got to the dunes. You know, usually it's at the end of the day, the sea line dunes, where the sun is on top. We cannot see the dunes, so we cannot go fast. Today was in the morning, so we pushed. Visibility was really good in the morning, and we got a lot of time on the others there in the dunes. So that was really good, and then we did good navigation. Xavier did an amazing job today, and we tried not to puncture, not to make mistakes, and try to keep a good pace, and yeah, take it to the finish. And we finished third, 20 seconds from second, but you know, I'm not going to complain about that.
The cars that you have at home, if somebody have an SUV, it's quite similar, just this car can take really a lot of beating.
Normal car, a road car, every people can go to the dealer and buy it. A racing car, as you see on the C-Line Rally in Qatar, it's a car that we developed, but also that we built from zero. We built this prototype, maybe only as a Toyota is a light of the car and part of the engine. The rest is homemade, is a pure prototype that we develop in Belgium.
Yeah, the main difference is, and the most important, is the safety. So the chassis, the basic structure is much more reinforced. Yeah, and then number two is that the ability to go through the desert or the dunes. This car has a system of jacks that it lift completely the car. And so then you can really put the sand out of the tires and you can continue, so it's much quicker. And then in terms of power, we have much powerful engine. We have a gearbox that is also quicker to change, and a lot of cooling. Cooling is also the number three difference, I would say, because we have a lot of cooling for the brakes, for the dampers, for the engine. When we talk about fuel, for example, these cars have a fuel tank of close to 400 liters, which is a lot. And we have as well three spare tires. So compared to the other rally cars and other competitions, is the place where we have more spare tires.
If you try to make some race with your home car, like we do, you will maybe make 100 km maximum.
Ah, today was a very difficult stage, very difficult for navigation. But the first 37 kilometers, we caught the first car in front of us, and we decided to stick behind. Because that's the best. If they got lost, you got lost. For us, with the less experience, you know, yesterday we lost 5 minutes. The day before, we lost 15 minutes. It's easy to lose more. So I decided to stick in front of the car in front of me and just kept it almost 300 kilometers just behind him. So it was not much of a joy for sure, because you're not using a lot of navigation because you're following. But it's better than frustrating, losing minutes and minutes and minutes, losing the tracks.
Yeah, the stage is hard, you know, not easy, and we open all the way, but okay, we try to no make any risk, and we are quite happy.
Today's stage number four was quite good for us. We're pushing really good half of the stage, and then we catch Shaboisa and Poulter, and then it was big mess with the dust, and we couldn't overtake. Then we overtake the guys, and then we get the punctures two times, and then we had to change the wheels, and it was big mess. But the speed was really good. Tomorrow is the last stage, and tomorrow we have to fight a lot.
Today was a good stage. Well, difficult navigation. We had some issues in the first kilometers, not so many, but then Poulter and Kuba caught us. We stayed with them for 200 kilometers. I had my first puncture. Then my throttle got stuck at full speed, 100 k's before the finish. It wasn't very easy to drive, but we managed, you know, with the brakes and the clutch. And then a second puncture, you know, because you couldn't control the throttle. So I hit another rock, puncture a second time, second tire change. And then we tried to take it to the finish as much as we can. We stayed with Kuba, so he beat us by 4 minutes, you know, and the Poulter by 2 minutes. So it was a good day overall. The times between us is really, really tight, and it will be tomorrow really big fight between four of us. We'll see what will happen.
Tomorrow it's flat out. We're 9 minutes from first, 2 minutes from fourth, 2 minutes from third. You know, it's all, everyone's very stuck, so we're gonna push as much as we can and see what happens.
It is definitely, you know, a daunting. It's a feeling that you kind of get used to. The speed, you get used to it. Of course, it's dangerous. It's but the whole point, you know, cross-country rallying teaches you how to be as safe as possible, going as fast as you can.
Sometimes when it is a rocky and stone, as you said, and a small sharp bump or a curve, a blind small blind curve, it can hide for you a big surprise.
The last stage of Qatar Cross-Country Rally was really good for us. We were pushing from the beginning. Of course, hard navigation, and Tom was navigating us really good. It was easy to get puncture, but we were lucky we passed all the stones. And the last part was with the dunes. It was not so easy to drive. And we are happy because we won the stage today, and we finished the race on second position.
Yeah, today we had a day of opening the stage again, and very difficult with the navigation. But we were very unlucky at the end of the stage. We couldn't get over one of the dunes, and we reversed back and got stuck on some camel grass, so we lost 2 minutes. It's unfortunate we lost the second overall for the seeding. So we third for the first time. Yeah, we're happy with it.
It was not easy rally, you know, we have a lot of problem, you know, because okay, this car is only for test car, you know, not the original car for rally, because after the accident in Abu Dhabi, We don't have extra car and we use the test car. But okay, we did good job and we win.
I think it's a very good rally to come and do, especially if you want to learn a lot about navigation. It's very good for the co-driver.
I'm really happy with Tom. We are really happy both that this is my first podium in the cars, and that's why I'm more happy than enough.
Yeah, it was not easy, every day difficult, but okay. I'm quite happy to win Qatar Cross Country. It was really nice, and thanks for the team, thanks for everything, you know.
Navigation is difficult, more difficult than other rallies. The other thing is the terrain, because the terrain can change on you very, very quickly. You can go from rocks to sand dunes.
All week racing here in Qatar was really nice. I enjoyed this race.
It's got a little bit of everything, a little bit of fast stuff, a lot of rocks and dunes every day, which is important if you're going to go and race the Dakar.
Some of the scenes that we have in this rally, you know, driving along the beach and sea line, it has nice scenes. So it has a nice variety. It's difficult, but it seems that everybody is enjoying it.
I try to enjoy every day. You know, when I enjoy, I give everything from my heart. This is why we are fast.